क्वेश्चन, व्हाट इज द मिनिमम एज एट विच यू कैन गेट ए क्लास सी ड्राइवर लाइसेंस विदाउट ईदर ड्राइवर एजुकेशन और बीइंग ए हार्डशिप केस? ऑप्शन नंबर 1 15, ऑप्शन नंबर 2 18, ऑप्शन नंबर 3 25. The answer is option number 3, 25. Note, without driver education, the minimum age at which you can apply for Class C driver license is 25 years. Minimum age for applying for Class C driver license is 16 to 24 years, required to successfully complete an approved driver education course. 25 years and above, without driver education or being a hardship case, 15 years with the approval of a hardship license. Question: how much is the maximum fine for a first conviction of driving without a license? Option number 1, $100. Option number 2, $200. Option number 3, $300. The answer is option number 2, $200. Note, conviction penalty. First conviction, a fine of up to $200. Second conviction in 1 year, a fine of $25 to $200. Driving without a license, insurance at the time of the driver causes a crash resulting in serious bodily injury or death. Class A misdemeanor punishable by a fine of up to $4,000 and or confinement in jail for not more than 365 days. Question: what type of restrictions may be placed on your license? A restriction may be placed on your license. This is not meant to interfere with your driving but to make you a better driver. Refer the full list of restrictions. Pause the video to go through. Question: in what direction should you turn your wheels when parking uphill without a curb? Option number 1. Turn wheels to the right. Option number 2, turn wheels to the left. Option number 3, keep the wheels parallel to the road. The answer is option number 1, turn wheels to the right. Question: what action should you take if you fail to receive the renewal notice card reminding you that your driver license is about to expire? Option number 1. You have option to inform DPS about non-receipt or renewal notice after 6 weeks of license expiry. Option 2. It is your responsibility to renew your license regardless of notice received or not. Option 3. You can continue driving with expired driving license till the notice arrives without any consequences. The answer is option 2. It is your responsibility to renew your license regardless of notice received or not. Note: a renewal notice invitation may be mailed to the last address you provided to DPS about 6 weeks before your license expires. If you do not receive this code C notice, it is your responsibility to renew your license. Question: on a one-way street, what color is the broken lane marker? Option number 1. Gray. Option number 2, yellow. Option number 3, white. The answer is option number 3, white. Note: broken lane marker in a one-way street is white colored. Yellow lines mark the center of a two-way road used for two-way traffic. Question: the red and white sign means? Option number 1, other drivers must yield to you. Option number 2, give the right of way to other drivers. Option number 3, make a complete stop before asserting your right of way. The answer is option number 2, give the right of way to other drivers. Note: yield sign indicates that you must slow down and be ready to stop, if necessary, to let any vehicle, bicyclist or pedestrian pass before you proceed. Question: how should the driver react when he sees the narrow bridge sign? Option number 1. Slow down and use caution. Option number 2. Proceed with normal speed. Option number 3. Stop and proceed with caution. The answer is option number 1. Slow down and use caution. Note: the bridge ahead is not as wide as the road. Slow down and use caution. Question: what is the shape of a keep right sign and how should the driver react when he sees one? Vertical white rectangle. Drivers who are driving slower than other vehicles on the roadway should keep right. Stay in the right hand lane if you are driving slower than other vehicles on the road. A yellow diamond that has two arrows pointing up and down, he should keep to the right lane. You should drive in the right hand lane and expect oncoming traffic in the left hand lane. Question: which sign tells you to slow down because you are approaching a double curve? Option number 1. Sign A. Option number 2. Sign B. Option number 3. Sign C. The answer is option number 3. Sign C. Question: what does a do not pass sign mean? Option number 1. Do not pass fast moving vehicles. Option number 2. Do not pass slow moving vehicles. Option number 3. Do not pass other vehicles. The answer is option number 3. Do not pass other vehicles. Question: which sign tells you to keep in the right hand lane when driving slow? Option number 1. Sign A. Option number 2. Sign B. Option number 3. Sign C. The answer is option number 2. Sign B. Stay in the right hand lane if you are driving slower than other vehicles on the road. Question: what does ill right of way mean? Option number 1. Slow down and be prepared to stop and give way to all traffic if there is any danger of a collision. Option number 2. Stop and give way to all traffic even if the intersection is clear. Option number 3. Slow down and be prepared to give way to traffic on your right only if there is any danger of a collision. The answer is option number 1. Slow down and be prepared to stop and give way to all traffic if there is any danger of a collision. This sign tells you the road you are on joins with another road ahead. You should slow down or stop if necessary so you can yield the right of way to vehicles, pedestrians or bicycles on the other road. Question: describe the equipment required on passenger cars by state law. Please go through the description of different equipments. Question: what is the purpose of an exhaust emission system? Option number 1. To decrease sound pollution. Option number 2. To increase efficiency of the engine. Option number 3. To reduce air pollution. The answer is option number 3. To reduce air pollution. Question: describe the types of equipment that Texas state law specially forbids on passenger cars driven within the state. Equipment you must not have. The following equipment is considered unsafe and is not allowed on your vehicle. Number 1. A red light showing from the front except on an emergency vehicle. Number 2. A bell, siren or exhaust whistle except on an emergency vehicle. Number 3. A muffler cutout. Number 4. Anything extending more than 3 inches beyond the left side or 6 inches beyond the right side of the body, running board or fenders of your car. Number 5. Flashing red lights on the front except on emergency vehicles, school buses and church buses. Number 6. A radar interference device designed, manufactured, used or intended to be used to interfere with, scramble, disrupt or cause to malfunction a radar or laser device used to measure a vehicle's speed. Question: how should you react when a traffic officer tells you to do something that is ordinarily considered to be against the law? Option number 1. You must obey the traffic officer at all times. Option number 2. You have the option to ignore as you are following the law. Option number 3. You must not go against the law even if officer directs you. The answer is option number 1. You must obey the traffic officer at all times. Note: drivers must obey traffic signals except when a law enforcement officer is directing traffic. You must obey a law enforcement officer at all times when they are directing traffic, even if he or she is telling you to do something which is ordinarily considered against the law. Question: once the brakes have been applied, about how many feet does a car which was going 70 miles per hour travel before it comes to a stop? Option number 1, 154. Option number 2, 233. Option number 3, 387. The answer is option number 2, 233. Note: for going 70 miles per hour, reaction distance is 154 feet. Braking distance of car is 233 feet. Total distance to stop is 387 feet. Question: when is it necessary to stop before proceeding when you overtake a school bus loading or unloading children? Option number 1. You may pass if no children are on the road. Option number 2. When the school bus stop sign are showing and red lights are flashing. Option number 3. You may pass if it is on the other side of a divided highway. The answer is option number 2. When the school bus stop sign are showing and red lights are flashing. Note: you should never overtake a school bus showing stop sign and red lights are flashing. Since it is loading or unloading children, you cannot drive again until the red lights stop flashing or school bus starts moving, or when the bus driver signals that you can proceed. You must stop for a school bus even if it is on the opposite side of a divided highway. Question: about how many feet will the average driver going 50 miles per hour travel from the moment he sees danger until he hits the brakes? Option number 1, 110. Option number 2, 119. Option number 3, 229. The answer is option number 1, 110. Note: for going 50 miles per hour, reaction distance is 110 feet. Brake distance of car is 119 feet. Total distance to stop is 229 feet. Question: within how many feet of a crosswalk you may park when parking near a corner? Option number 1, 15. Option number 2, 20. Option number 3, 30. The answer is option number 2, 20. Note: do not park or stand a vehicle. Number 1, in front of a public or private driveway. Number 2, within 50 feet of a fire hydrant. Number 3, within 20 feet of a crosswalk at an intersection. Number 4, within 30 feet of flashing signal, stop sign, yield sign or other traffic signal. Number 5, within 20 feet of the driveway entrance to any fire station and on the side of a street opposite the entrance to any fire station within 75 feet of entrance. Number 6, at any place where an official sign prohibits parking or standing. Question: what is the state speed limit for automobiles in urban districts? Option number 1, 15 miles per hour. Option number 2, 30 miles per hour. Option number 3, 50 miles per hour. The answer is option number 2, 30 miles per hour. Note: go through the different speed limits. Question: does a posted speed limit of 55 miles per hour mean that you may drive 55 miles per hour on that highway under all conditions? Option number 1. You may never drive faster than posted speed limits of 55 miles per hour. Option number 2. You should never drive faster than is safe for current conditions. Option number 3. As a safe driving practice, always drive slower than posted speed limit. The answer is option number 2. You should never drive faster than is safe for current conditions. Note, you may never drive faster than is safe for current conditions. Regardless of the posted speed limit, your speed should depend on number and speed of other vehicles on the road, condition of road surface, bicyclists or pedestrians on or crossing the roadway and weather conditions. Under adverse conditions, you may be required to drive at slower than the posted speed limit. Question: you should never drive on the left half of the roadway when you are within how many feet from an intersection, bridge or railroad crossing? Option number 1, 50 feet. Option number 2, 75 feet. Option number 3, 100 feet. The answer is option number 3, 100 feet. Note: never drive on the left side of the road when number 1. Pavement markings or signs prohibit driving on the left. Number 2. There are two or more traffic lanes in each direction. Number 3. Within 100 feet of or crossing an intersection or railroad crossing. Number 4. On a hill, curve or any other place where vision is limited. Number 5. Within 100 feet of a bridge, viaduct or tunnel. Question: what should you do if you discover you are in the wrong lane to make a turn as you enter an intersection? Option number 1. Get into the proper lane in the intersection without stopping. Option number 2. Slow your vehicle and signal to get into the proper lane. Option number 3. Don't turn and continue straight ahead in the lane to find a safe turn further up the road. The answer is option number 3. Don't turn and continue straight ahead in the lane to find a safe turn further up the road. Question: when two cars meet at the intersection of a two-lane road with a four-lane road, which one must yield the right of way? Option number 1. The car on the two-lane road should yield. Option number 2. The car on the four-lane road should yield. Option number 3. The car which reached the intersection first has the right of way. The answer is option number 1. The car on the two-lane road should yield. Note: if you are driving on a single or two-lane road that intersects with a divided road or road with three or more lanes, you must yield the right of way to vehicles traveling on the divided or three or more lane road. Question: if you are driving and hear a siren coming, what should you do? Option number 1. Keep driving until you see the vehicle. Option number 2. Pull to the curb and look to see if it is on your street. Option number 3. Slow down but don't stop until you see it. The answer is option number 2. Pull to the curb and look to see if it is on your street. Note: if you hear a siren close by but do not know exactly where the emergency vehicle is, you can safely pull over to the right side edge of the road and stop until you are sure it is not headed towards you. Question: what is the first thing that should be done when a car starts to skid? Option number 1. Brake quickly and keep the wheel straight. Option number 2. Lock your brakes until you have come to a complete stop. Option number 3. Take your foot off the gas pedal and steer in the direction of the skid. The answer is option number 3. Take your foot off the gas pedal and steer in the direction of the skid. Note: if your car starts to skid on slippery road, take your foot off the gas pedal and turn the steering wheel in the direction of the skid. Don't brake hard. Question: at what time of the day should your headlights be turned on? Option number 1. Anytime you can't see at least 2 miles ahead. Option number 2. Anytime you have trouble seeing others or being seen. Option number 3. 30 minutes before sunset until 30 minutes before sunrise. The answer is option number 2. Anytime you have trouble seeing others or being seen. Note: You must use the headlights beginning 30 minutes after sunset and ending 30 minutes before sunrise, or any time when individuals or vehicles cannot see clearly for at least 1000 feet. Question: under what conditions may your driver license be suspended? Option number 1: overtaking and passing a school bus. Option number 2: driving while license invalid. Option number 3: any of above. The answer is option number 3, any of above. Note: some of the conditions which may result in driver license suspension are: number 1, driving while intoxicated by use of alcohol or drugs. Number 2, causing death or serious injury to anyone. Number 3, overtaking and passing a school bus. Number 4, racing a motor vehicle on a public highway or street. Number 5, evading arrest. Number 6, driving while license invalid. Number 7, altered or unlawful use of a driver license. Number 8, displaying or possessing a fictitious or altered driver license or ID card. Number 9, providing false information or documents when applying for a driver license. Number 10, fictitious license plate registration. Question: what is carbon monoxide and how may it be harmful to drivers? Option number 1: it is a colorless deadly gas produced by car exhaust and can cause poisoning. Option number 2: it is a yellow colored deadly gas produced by car exhaust and can cause poisoning. Option number 3: it is a yellow colored car exhaust gas which decreases car engine longevity. The answer is option number 1. It is a colorless deadly gas produced by car exhaust and can cause poisoning. Question: describe what should you do if you have a blowout while driving. Option number 1: speed up to gain traction and then pull to the right. Option number 2: hold the steering wheel straight and ease up on the gas. Option number 3: apply the brakes, then shift into neutral. The answer is option number 2. Hold the steering wheel straight and ease up on the gas. Note: if you have a flat tire or a blowout, do not hit the brakes suddenly and hard. Take your foot off the gas pedal and gently apply the brakes. Steer straight ahead to a stop. Question: what should you do when driving down a steep grade in a car with standard transmission? Option number 1: control steering wheel straight and ease up on the gas. Option number 2: shift into neutral and apply the brakes to control. Option number 3: shift your car into a lower gear to help slow your vehicle. The answer is option number 3. Shift your car into a low gear to help slow your vehicle. Note: when driving down a steep hill, you can shift your car into a low gear to help slow your vehicle. Never coast in neutral, or for cars with a standard transmission, never coast with your foot on the clutch. Question: what should you do if you damage an unattended vehicle? Option number 1: stop your vehicle to check owner. If not available, report the crash details to law enforcement officer. Option number 2: report the crash incident to law enforcement officer. Option number 3: stop your vehicle and attach a written notice to the unattended vehicle providing your name and address. The answer is option number 3. Stop your vehicle and attach a written notice to the unattended vehicle providing your name and address. Note: if you are operating a motor vehicle that collides with and damages an unattended vehicle, you must immediately stop and either: number 1, locate the operator or owner of the unattended vehicle and give your name and address. Number 2, securely attach a written notice in a visible way to the unattended vehicle providing your name, address, and also a statement of the circumstances of the collision. Question: when are crash reports required? Option number 1: there is an injury or fatality. Option number 2: when a law enforcement officer hasn't investigated the crash. Option number 3: damage to property of $2,000 or more? The answer is option number 2. When a law enforcement officer hasn't investigated the crash. Note: if you are involved in a crash that is not investigated by a law enforcement officer and the crash has not resulted in injury or death of a person or damage of property of $1,000 or more, you must make a written report of the crash and file it with the Texas Department of Transportation no later than the 10th day after the date of the crash. Question: if you are required to show proof of financial responsibility for the future, how many years must such proof be kept up? Option number 1, 1 year. Option number 2, 2 year. Option number 3, 3 year. The answer is option number 2, 2 year. Question: what type of sign wants you to watch right and left for cross traffic? Option number 1, sign A. Option number 2, sign B. Option number 3, sign C. The answer is option number 2, sign B. Cross road ahead, slow down and watch for cross traffic. Look carefully in all directions for traffic. Question: the emblem that identifies vehicles which travel at speed of 25 miles per hour or less? Option number 1, sign A. Option number 2, sign B. Option number 3, sign C. The answer is option number 3, sign C. Note: farm tractors, animal drawn carts and road maintenance vehicles usually travel 25 miles per hour or less. Slow moving vehicles have an orange or red triangle on the back of the vehicle. Question: in which gear should you drive when going down a steep hill? Option number 1, neutral gear. Option number 2, high gear. Option number 3, low gear. The answer is option number 3, low gear. Note: when driving down a steep hill, you can shift your car into a low gear to help slow your vehicle. Never coast in neutral or for cars with a standard transmission. Never coast with your foot on the clutch. Question: what qualifications and actions must one undertake to teach a beginner to drive? Option number 1, should be a licensed driver and must be at least 21 years of age with at least 1 year of driving experience. Option number 2, must occupy the seat beside the driver and respond to the actions of the driver and he cannot be intoxicated. Option number 3, all of the above. The answer is option number 3. All of the above. Question: if the person is under 18, when does his provisional license expire? Option number 1, 1 year. Option number 2, expires on the 18th birthday of the person. Option number 3, 6 years. The answer is option number 2, expires on the 18th birthday of the person. Note: the learner license of a minor shall expire on his 18th birthday. Question: when parked parallel, your curbside wheels must be no more than how many inches from the curb? Option number 1, 16 inches. Option number 2, 18 inches. Option number 3, 20 inches. The answer is option number 2, 18 inches. Note: do not park more than 18 inches from the curb or edge of the road. Question: when following another car, what is a good distance at which you should follow behind? Option number 1, for speeds above 30 miles per hour, maintain a 4-second gap between cars. Option number 2, for speeds 30 miles per hour or less, maintain a 2-second gap between cars. Option number 3, all of above. The answer is option number 3, all of above. Note: you should keep a safe distance between your car and the one in front of you. The faster you drive, the greater the distance you should keep from the car ahead of you. Using a 4-second following interval is the best practice for a beginning or less experienced driver. Question: to what agency and within what time period must a change of address be reported for driver licensing purposes? Option number 1, it must be reported to the driver license office within 10 days. Option number 2. It must be reported to the driver license office within 30 days. Option number 3. It must be reported to the driver license office within 45 days. The answer is option number 2. It must be reported to the driver license office within 30 days. Question. What effects does the use of marijuana and amphetamine have on driving? Option number 1. It harms both driving skills and judgment. Option number 2. It has no effect on either driving skills or judgment. Option number 3. It has no effect on judgment but it harms driving skills. The answer is option number 1. It harms both driving skills and judgment. Note. Marijuana can affect concentration, judgment, and sensory and perceptual skills needed for careful driving. Amphetamine makes a driver less coordinated, edgy, and is more likely to be involved in a car crash. Question. What is the penalty for being convicted of driving while intoxicated? Go through the list of penalties for driving while intoxicated for adults. You may pause the video. Question. What does a green arrow showing with a red light mean? Option number 1. Proceed carefully in the direction of the arrow. Option number 2. Proceed carefully in the direction of the arrow after yielding the right of way to other vehicles and pedestrians. Option number 3. Warns driver to slow down and proceed with caution. The answer is option number 2. Proceed carefully in the direction of the arrow after yielding the right of way to other drivers and pedestrians. Question. How should you react to a flashing red light? Option number 1. Warns drivers to slow down and proceed with caution. Option number 2. Warns drivers to use caution and to alert them the light is about to change to red. Option number 3. Stop completely before entering the crosswalk or intersection, then proceed when you can do so safely. The answer is option number 3. Stop completely before entering the crosswalk or intersection, then proceed when you can do so safely. Question. Which sign tells you to watch out for a train? Option number 1. Sign A. Option number 2. Sign B. Option number 3. Sign C. The answer is all of above. Question. Describe the sign that warns you to slow down for a winding road. Option number 1. Sign A. Option number 2. Sign B. Option number 3. Sign C. The answer is option number 1. Sign A. There is a winding road ahead. Drive slowly and carefully and do not pass. Question. What sign indicates that the road that you are on merges with another? Option number 1. Sign A. Option number 2. Sign B. Option number 3. Sign C. The answer is option number 2. Sign B. You are approaching a point where other traffic lanes come together with the one you are in. Watch for traffic from that direction. Question. What kind of sign warns you that the highest speed for the turn ahead is 35 miles per hour? Advisory speed sign. This sign gives the highest speed for which you can safely travel around the curve ahead. Question. Describe the sign that tells you to watch for cross traffic ahead. Option number 1. Sign A. Option number 2. Sign B. Option number 3. Sign C. The answer is option number 1. Sign A. Crossroad ahead, slow down and watch for cross traffic. Look carefully in all directions for traffic. Question. What type of sign warns you that you should slow down for a sharp rise in the roadway? Option number 1. Sign A. Option number 2. Sign B. Option number 3. Sign C. The answer is option number 3. Sign C. There is a sudden high place in the road ahead. Slow down in order to avoid losing control of your vehicle or an uncomfortable jolt. Question. Describe the type of sign that would let you know that you were on a short state highway in a city or urban area. Option number 1. Sign A. ऑप्शन नंबर टू साइन बी, ऑप्शन नंबर थ्री साइन सी. द आंसर इज ऑप्शन नंबर वन साइन ए. टेक्सस रूट मार्कर साइंस टेल यू व्हाट रोड यू आर और विल बी ट्रेवलिंग ऑन. प्लान योर ट्रिप एंड नो व्हिच रोड यू वांट टू टेक. क्वेश्चन, व्हाट इज द मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ इंचेस यू मे लॉफुली अलाउ एन ऑब्जेक्ट टू एक्सटेंड बियॉन्ड द लेफ्ट फेंडर ऑफ योर कार. ऑप्शन नंबर वन, एक्सटेंडिंग मोर देन 2 inches बियॉन्ड द लेफ्ट साइड. ऑप्शन नंबर टू, एक्सटेंडिंग मोर देन 3 inches बियॉन्ड द लेफ्ट साइड. ऑप्शन नंबर थ्री, एक्सटेंडिंग मोर देन 6 inches बियॉन्ड द लेफ्ट साइड. The answer is option number 2, extending more than 3 inches beyond the left side. Note, anything extending more than 3 inches beyond the left side or 6 inches beyond the right side of the body, running body or fender of your car. Question, under what conditions must you always stop? Option number 1, steady red light. Option number 2, steady yellow light. Option number 3, all of above. The answer is option number 3, all of above. Note, you must always stop at stop signs, red lights, crosswalks, pedestrians and for school buses and emergency vehicles. Question, what should you do when coming onto a street from a private alley or driveway? Option number 1, you should stop prior to the sidewalk and yield the right of way to all approaching pedestrians. Option number 2, you should slow down prior to the sidewalk and yield the right of way to all approaching pedestrians. Option number 3, yield the right of way to all approaching vehicles and pedestrians. The answer is option number 1. You should stop prior to the sidewalk and yield the right of way to all approaching pedestrians. Note, when entering or crossing a road, street or highway from a private road, alley, building or driveway, you must stop prior to the sidewalk and yield the right of way to all approaching vehicles and pedestrians. Question, if a child runs into the road 45 to 50 feet ahead of your car, what is the highest speed from which you can stop with good brakes without hitting him? Option number 1, 20 miles per hour. Option number 2, 30 miles per hour. Option number 3, 40 miles per hour. The answer is option number 2, 30 miles per hour. Note, at 30 miles per hour, a vehicle has a braking distance of 43 feet. Question, how close to a fire plug may a vehicle lawfully park? Option number 1, not closer than 5 feet of a fire hydrant. Option number 2, not closer than 10 feet of a fire hydrant. Option number 3, not closer than 15 feet of a fire hydrant. The answer is option number 3, not closer than 15 feet of a fire hydrant. Note, whether occupied or not, do not park or allow a vehicle to stand idle within 15 feet of a fire hydrant. Question, what does a posted speed limit of 55 miles per hour mean? Option number 1, indicates the maximum speed permitted on the road for daytime. Option number 2, indicates the maximum speed permitted on the road for nighttime. Option number 3, indicates the maximum speed permitted on the road for daytime and nighttime. The answer is option number 3, indicates the maximum speed permit on the road for the daytime and nighttime. This sign tells you the maximum speed in miles per hour you are permitted to travel. Sign also indicates the maximum speed permitted on the road for daytime and nighttime. Question, what is the maximum speed limit for passenger cars on a Texas highway numbered by the state or United States outside an urban district? Option number 1, 50 miles per hour. Option number 2, 60 miles per hour. Option number 3, 70 miles per hour. The answer is option number 3, 70 miles per hour. Question, under what circumstances should you never attempt to pass a car ahead of you? Option number 1, within 50 feet of or crossing an intersection or railroad crossing. Option number 2, within 50 feet of or crossing an intersection or railroad crossing. Option number 3, there are 2 or more traffic lanes in each direction. The answer is option number 3. There are two or more traffic lanes in each direction. Note: never drive on the left side of the road when number 1. Pavement markings or signs prohibit driving on the left. Number 2. There are two or more traffic lanes in each direction. Number 3. Within 100 feet of or crossing an intersection or railroad crossing. Number 4. On a hill, curve or any other place where vision is limited. Number 5. Within 100 feet of a bridge, viaduct or tunnel. Question: under what conditions are overtaking and passing to the right not permitted? Option number 1. If you need to drive off the paved portion of the highway. Option number 2. You are on a one-way road. Option number 3. All of above. The answer is option number 1. If you need to drive off the paved portion of the highway. Note: overtaking and passing to the right not permitted when there are parked cars on the road, when there is no paved shoulder, when driving on a multi-lane road and there is blocked traffic. Question: when a driver is waiting to make a left turn, what is the procedure he should take when the light turns green? Option number 1. You can turn left on a green light. Option number 2. You must yield the right of way to all traffic that is approaching from the opposite direction before turning. Option number 3. All of above. The answer is option number 3. All of above. Question: what precautions should a driver take at uncontrolled intersections? Option number 1. Yield the right of way to any vehicle on your right. Option number 2. Yield the right of way to any vehicle on your left. Option number 3. All of above. The answer is option number 1. Yield the right of way to any vehicle on your right. Note: when approaching this type of intersection, yield the right of way to any vehicle that has entered or is approaching the intersection on your right. If the road to your right is clear or if approaching vehicles are far enough from the intersection to make your crossing safe, you may proceed. Since there are not any traffic controls at this intersection, make sure there are no approaching vehicles from the left. You may legally have the right of way, but be sure the other driver yields to you before you proceed. Question: what regulations should a bicycle rider observe? Option number 1. Penalties for violating a traffic law as a person operating a motor vehicle is severe than for bicycle rider. Option number 2. Penalties for violating a traffic law as a bicycle rider is severe than a person operating a motor vehicle. Option number 3. Any person who operates a bicycle is subject to the same penalties for violating a traffic law as a person operating a motor vehicle. The answer is option number 3. Any person who operates a bicycle is subject to the same penalties for violating a traffic law as a person operating a motor vehicle. Question: under what conditions should headlights be used? Option number 1. Driving in fog, heavy rain, snow or dust. Option number 2. Anytime when visibility is reduced at night or in a tunnel. Option number 3. All of above. The answer is option number 3. All of above. Question: you should dim your lights when you are within how many feet of an approaching car? Option number 1. Within 250 feet. Option number 2. Within 500 feet. Option number 3. Within 1000 feet. The answer is option number 2. Within 500 feet. Question: what type of lighting should cars use when parked on the highway at night? Option number 1. Leave your parking lights on. Option number 2. Leave your low beam headlights on. Option number 3. Any of the above. The answer is option number 3. Any of the above. Note: if you must park on an unlighted highway at night, leave your parking lights or low beam headlights on. Question: which lights should you use when you are driving in a fog? Option number 1. Parking lights on. Option number 2. Low beam headlights. Option number 3. High beam headlights. The answer is option number 2. Low beam headlights. Note: headlights on high beams reflect rain, fog and snow as it falls. This making it even harder for you to see. For better visibility during these weather conditions, keep your headlights on low beam. Question: when are you required to show proof of financial responsibility? Option number 1: to a law enforcement officer. Option number 2: to another person involved in a crash. Option number 3: any of the above. The answer is option number 3: any of the above. Note: every owner or operator of a motor vehicle in Texas is required to furnish evidence of financial responsibility to a law enforcement officer upon request or to another person involved in a crash. Question: when needed, how may one show proof of financial responsibility? Option number 1: a physical standard insurance certificate issued by an insurance company. Option number 2: an image displayed on a wireless communication device that includes the information required in a standard insurance form. Option number 3: any of the above. The answer is option number 3: any of the above. Question: what sign warns you that you must slow down? Many of the yellow diamond warning signs require you to slow down for safety. Question: what circumstances may lead to possible loss of your license? Circumstances which may lead to loss of your license are: suspension or revocation action from another state, parental authorization withdrawn, voluntary surrender for medical or insurance purposes, false statement on application. Question: in addition to mufflers, what new equipment is required on all cars manufactured in 1968 and after? Option number 1: front safety belts. Option number 2: exhaust system. Option number 3: safety glass. The answer is option number 2: exhaust system. Question: why are seat belts important? Option number 1: from being thrown from a car. Option number 2: from hitting the dashboard too hard. Option number 3: all of the above. The answer is option number 3: all of the above. Note: safety belts help keep you: number 1, from being thrown from your car. Your chances of being killed are 5 times greater if you are thrown from your car. Number 2, from hitting the dashboard too hard. Whatever your reason for not wearing seat belts, it is dangerous and violates state law. Question: what is meant by defensive driving? To avoid crashes, the defensive driver should: number 1, stay alert and keep eyes moving to keep track of what is happening at all times. Number 2, look for trouble spots developing all around. Number 3, have a plan of action. Number 4, know that the law requires drivers to protect each other from their own mistakes. Question: what are the different classes of licenses and age requirements for each? Go through the different classes of licenses and age requirements. Question: when is a bicyclist not required to ride to the right of the roadway? Option number 1: passing or overtaking. Option number 2: unsafe conditions in roadway. Option number 3: all of the above. The answer is option number 3: all of the above. Note: a person operating a bicycle who is moving slower than the other traffic on the road shall ride as near as possible to the right curb or edge of the road unless: while passing or overtaking, during left turn at intersection, due to unsafe conditions of roadway, lane width is inappropriate. Question: when are bicyclists allowed to ride two abreast in a traffic lane? Option number 1: ride in a single lane. Option number 2: ride in multiple lanes. Option number 3: if required, may impede flow of traffic. The answer is option number 1: ride in a single lane. Note: Individuals riding two abreast on a laned road must ride in a single lane and not impede the flow of traffic. Question: what are the three most common motorist-caused car-bicycle crashes? The most common car-bicycle crashes caused by a motorist are: Number 1. Motorist turning left in front of oncoming bicycle traffic. Number 2. Motorist turning right across path of bicycle traffic. Number 3. Motorist pulling away from a stop sign or failing to yield to bicycle cross traffic. Question: what are the penalties for minors, persons under the age of 21, convicted of driving under the influence of alcohol? Refer to different penalties for minors convicted of driving under the influence of alcohol. Question: what are the penalties for minors, persons under the age of 21, convicted of non-driving alcohol-related offenses? Refer to different penalties for minors convicted of non-driving alcohol-related offenses.